Hi children, welcome to the EduCup. So we are with new lesson today from grade 8 science, animal classification, unit 2. There is a vast diversity among animals that live in our environment. It is easy to study about them by classifying organisms based on different criteria. Grouping of animals in systematic way by considering their common features is known as animal classification. Grouping of animals in a systematic way by considering their common features is known as animal classification. You have to do a small activity. I'm going to give you a set of pictures of animals. So, divide and tabulate them into two groups using the feature presence or absence of vertebral column. These are the pictures: snail, crab, yellowfin tuna, dog, cock, butterfly, python, spider, lion. So then you can tabulate it like this: have a backbone and do not have a backbone. What animals have a backbone? Yellowfin tuna, dog, cock, python and lion. Do not have backbone: snail, crab, butterfly, spider. You can tabulate this with the using of your grade 7 knowledge. So, the animals without a backbone or vertebral column are known as invertebrates. The animals without a backbone or vertebral column are known as invertebrates. The animals with a backbone or vertebral column are known as vertebrates. Therefore, animals can be classified into two groups as invertebrates and vertebrates. Let's see the main invertebrate groups. Invertebrates are scientifically classified by using their common features. Some of groups are you have to learn in this lesson. Let's see what are that four groups are. Cnidaria, C is silent here, Annelida, Mollusca and Arthropoda. The first group is Cnidaria. The animals belong to Cnidaria are predators and they live in water. Let's see some examples: Hydra, sea anemone, jellyfish. The features of Cnidaria. Cnidaria have radially symmetrical body. That means if the body of an animal can be divided into two equal halves along several axes, we call it radially symmetrical animal. That Cnidaria can be divided into equal halves along several axes. Second one, there are two forms as polyps and medusa. Polyps are fixed to the substrate and lead a sedentary life, while medusa are free floating organisms. Polyps example is sea anemone. Medusa is example is the crippled small creatures with their special tentacles having nicosites and use them as food. Next group is Annelida. Annelida live in both marine and freshwater environments as well as in wet terrestrial environment. Let's see some examples: earthworm, leech, nereids. Common features of annelids: body is bilaterally symmetrical. If the body of an animal can be divided into two equal halves along one axis, we call it bilaterally symmetrical animal. Second one is there are worm form, that means worm like body shape. Third one is body is divided into segments. Therefore, known as segmented worms. You can see that body is divided into different segments here. Next group is mollusca. Mollusca live in terrestrial, marine and freshwater environment. Let's say some example: snail, bivalve, octopus. The features of molluscas. First one, they are bilaterally symmetrical. Soft-bodied animal. Possesses a muscular foot. Possesses a skin moistened with mucus. Some molluscas bear shells. Next group is arthropoda. Arthropods live in terrestrial as well as in aquatic environments. Examples of arthropods are butterfly, scorpion, centipede, prawns. Arthropoda is the group of to which the highest number of animals belongs. They have the highest number of animals in arthropoda group. Features of arthropoda: the first one is arthropods are bilaterally symmetrical. Their body possesses an external skeleton, that means exoskeleton. They have exoskeleton. Some species possess wings. Arthropods have externally segmented body. Can you see the bottom of this picture? You can see that body is segmented. Fifth one, all arthropods have jointed appendages. The appendages, all of them are jointed. So this is what we have to learn throughout this lesson, invertebrates. So let me meet with the second part of this lesson, main vertebrate groups. Thank you.